Hey Java developers, JDK 24 has been released. Let's go through all the major changes coming in JDK 24 in 2 minutes, more or less. So we have 24 JEPs to get through, our biggest 6 month release yet, so let's get started. There are two major additions in JDK 24. JEP 484 finalizes the class file API. Most developers won't directly interact with the class file API, but it should make the process of upgrading past JDK 24 even easier. JEP 485 finalizes stream gatherers and would be a feature developers will use. Gatherers provide a new intermediate operation to streams that give developers considerable freedom and transformation of data coming into and out of a gatherer. There is also 5 runtime updates. JEP 475 adds late barrier expansion for the G1 garbage collector. This is a rather technical JEP. What is being changed is how C2 handles compilation of G1's write barriers, which should result into a 10 to 20% reduction in the overhead for C2 compilation. JEP 483 introduces the first Project Lyden feature, ahead of time class loading and linking. If you'd like to learn more about class loading and linking, check out my video on JVM startup. JEP 491 synchronized virtual threads without pinning addresses, an issue brought up in the feedback of virtual threads not unmounting when performing a blocking operation in a synchronized block. The most prominent example of this was covered in a June 2024 Netflix blog article, link in the description. JEP 493 linking runtime images without JMods reduces the size of the JDK by allowing JDKs to be shipped without the JMods file. Not all JDK distros will adopt this change, however, you'll need to check to see if your JDK distro adopts this JEP. JEPs 496 and 497 introduce a quantum-resistant latest based key encapsulation mechanism and digital signature algorithm. To understand what this means, check out this video from my colleague Anna Maria. There are a few deprecation and removals in JDK 24. The title for JEP 472, Prepare to Restrict the Use of JNI, is a bit confusing as it also applies to the new FFM API as well. The new goal is to help prevent Java developers from doing risky behavior and performing interoperability with native code. This is part of Integrity by Default. To learn more about this, watch this presentation by Ron Pressler. The name of JEP 479, remove the Windows 32 x86 port, says it all. Sorry, Windows 32-bit developers. Though Linux developers, bad news, JEP 501, deprecate the 32-bit x86 port for removal, applies to Linux, the only remaining 32-bit version. JEP 486 permanently disabled the security manager does just that. For additional details, be sure to read the JEP. JEP 490 removes the non-generational ZTC mode. Generational ZTC was added in JDK 21, was made default in JDK 23. This JEP completes the migration to generational ZTC. JEP 498 warned upon use of memory access methods in SUNMISC unsafe will issue a warning the first time a memory access method in SUNMISC unsafe is used. Alternative to these methods exist, please migrate to them. There are 6 JEPs previewing or incubating a feature. JEP 478 adds the key derivation function API as a preview feature. This can be used to create shared keys between 2 parties. JEP 487 re-previews scope values for the 4th and hopefully final time. Watch this video by Nikolai for more on scoped values. Primitive types in patterns enters second preview with JEP 488, which allows primitives int, boolean, byte, long, etc. to be used in pattern matching without being wrapped in a reference type. There have been no changes in this preview round. JEP 492 is the 3rd preview of flexible constructor bodies. This allows for statements before the call to super or this in a constructor. No significant changes included in this preview round. JEP 494 is module import declarations 2nd preview. This feature allows for the importing of an entire module's exported packages with a single line, like in this example. Some minor changes were made in this preview. Simple source file and instance main methods will be in 4th preview with JEP 495. This is part of the paving the on-ramp. Check the description for more information on that if interested. The goal is to finalize this feature in JDK 25. JEP 499 re-previews the structured concurrency API. However, expect a major update to the API in JDK 25. Vector API enters 9th incubator with JEP 489, where it will remain pending promotion of Valhalla features. There are 2 experimental features introduced in JDK 24. JEP 404 introduces the generational mode for Shenandoah GC, which would be included in the Red Hat OpenJDK distro. And JEP 450 adds compact object headers as an experimental feature. This is part of Project Lilliput. For more information, check the description. All right, that's all the major changes for the JDK 24 release. Until next time, Happy coding!